Management of class II malocclusion. Class II malocclusion can be broadly divided into dental and skeletal class II malocclusion. Dental class II malocclusion. Although most class II malocclusion are caused by a skeletal discrepancy or deformity, it is possible to have a normal skeletal jaw relationship associated with a dental class II malocclusion. The causes of this dental class II malocclusion can be subdivided into two groups: maxillary dental protrusion and mesial drift of the maxillary first permanent molars. Maxillary dental protrusion. It is not a skeletal problem, but a dental alveolar one that is limited to the maxillary dental arch. The cephalometric shows a normal anterior-posterior and vertical skeletal relationship characterized by a normal ANB, SNA, and SNB angle. The maxillary incisors will be in the protrusive position relative to the NA line, SN, and the Frankfurt horizontal. The feature of this dental malocclusion is excessive overjet, and there may be maxillary spacing associated with the protruded maxillary incisors. Mesial drift of the maxillary first permanent molars. Mesial and occlusal drift of the permanent first molars occurs if there is loss of mesial proximal contact with the second primary molars from congenital absence, extraction, and dental caries. The mesial drift is more pronounced if the lack of proximal contact occurs in the maxilla, or if the loss occurs before clinical emergence of the first permanent molar. Skeletal class II malocclusion. A skeletal class II malocclusion is an anterior-posterior disproportion in size, or discrepancy in position of the jaw. The abnormal skeletal features most often found are maxillary protrusion, mandibular retrusion, maxillary protrusion, and mandibular retrusion. Mandibular deficiency. A skeletal class II relationship resulting from the mandible that is small or retruded relative to the maxilla. A facial appearance characterized by a normal nasolabial angle, relative protrusion of the maxillary anterior teeth, and a relative deficiency of the chin caused by the small size or retruded position of the mandible. Cephalometric shows an increased ANB angle, a normal SNA angle with a decreased SNB angle. Steeper mandibular plane angle, an increased angle of convexity, and an increased overjet. Maxillary axis may present as overdevelopment in the vertical or anterior-posterior dimension of both. This condition is usually associated with an anterior open bite and gummy smile. Cephalometric shows increased ANB angle and SNA angle with a normal SNB angle. Treatment approaches for the dental class II malocclusion. There are two alternatives for treatment of dental class II malocclusion. A non-extrusion approach involving distal movement of the maxillary teeth, and the extrusion approach. The purpose is for gaining space to correct the dental malocclusion. Treatment approaches for skeletal class II malocclusion. There are three alternatives for treating any skeletal problems: growth modification, dental camouflage, and orthognathic surgery. Treatment plan for class II malocclusion in growing patient. A growing patient with skeletal class II malocclusion should be treated by growth modification. The goal of the treatment is to alter the unacceptable skeletal relationship
biomodifying the patient remaining facial growth to favorable change the size or position of the jaws. Basically, two types of orthodontic appliances are used for growth modification of class 2 skeletal problem: extraolar force appliance and functional appliance. Correction of maxillary protrusion. Hard cure appliances are used for orthopedic force growth inhibition of the maxilla. A headgear is designed to deliver an adequate extraoral orthopedic force to compress the maxillary sutures, modifying the pattern of bone opposition at this site. The goal of treatment is for restriction of maxillary growth to occur.
While the mandible continues to grow forward an adequate amount to catch up with the maxilla,
correction of mandibular deficiency. Functional appliances are used for growth stimulation of the mandible. The ideal indication for using the functional appliance is in class 2 malocclusion with mandibular deficiency. Class 2 functional appliances are designed to position the mandible downward and forward to stimulate or accelerate mandibular growth. Commonly used functional appliances for class 2 correction are activator, Frankel, twin block, and bionator. And some fixed functional appliances like herbs, jasper jumpers.
Treatment plan for class 2 correction in adult. Dental camouflage of class 2 skeletal problems. In patients who are beyond their growth phase, it is not possible to undertake growth modification procedures. Thus, the underlying skeletal discrepancy can be camouflaged by orthodontic tooth movement. This is often done by extraction of certain teeth and moving the rest of the teeth into the space created. Orthodontic camouflage may also be done by distal dropping of maxillary molars. It implies repositioning the teeth without correcting the skeletal problem. The goal is to disguise the undesirable skeletal relationship by orthodontically repositioning the teeth in the jaws, which makes the underlying skeletal problem less apparent. So there is an acceptable dental occlusion and aesthetic facial appearance. Ideal requirements for camouflage. First, adult patients who are not indicated for growth modification. Mild to moderate skeletal class 2 malocclusion. Good alignment teeth so that the extraction space is available for retraction and not for correction of crowding. Good vertical facial proportions. Surgical correction if class 2 skeletal discrepancy in adult. In patients with severe skeletal malrelationship, surgery may be the ideal treatment choice. Based on the underlying skeletal pattern, a maxillary setback or a mandibular advancement is undertaken after the completion of growth.